Imagine it's a Monday morning where David, a senior product lead, is already on his third coffee. The launch date of their new AI feature is just 6 weeks away. And he still does not know if the backend team started the API integrations and all. David toggling between 5 browser tabs, one Kanban board, one Sprint board, status, as well as Confluence documentations, Slack and everything, but informations are not at one place. Where David was looking for some solutions, a Gantt chart in Excel that updates manually, but over his shoulder, shot of his sighing, rubbing the temples, and he might struggling with all those informations to get it at one place. But worry not, I came up with one solution which will help David to achieve his task. One team is in Sprint 9, another team is tagging tasks as to review, a third team. So they are still using Google Sheets, and despite all one-on-one and Slack updates, David has no clear answers. The one question his VP keeps asking, are you on track? How David can show those details? He is not managing a project anymore. He is managing chaos. To resolve this, what could be the best way in Jira? You can use it. If you know the answers, feel free to add in the comment sections. I will try to cover each and everything details. Sounds familiar, right? How are you keeping track of multi-team projects in Jira? Drop your methods in the comments, even if it's just sticky notes. That is fine, but at least we'll get to know what type of actions people are using, or you'll also learn from other viewers as well. Just rewind 1 minute back what I said. Imagine David have one place where every project came together, whether he could track dependencies, team capacities, and delivery timelines across all his Jira boards. I will show you everything in detail. Worry not. If you wanted to learn Jira and the feature from scratch, feel free to be here from start to end of this video. Hi everyone, I'm Deepak Rai, and today I'm going to show you how Jira Plan works, how we can configure it, what best practices we can take to resolve our issues, what David is facing. This also helps team plan smarter, scale faster, and keep projects aligned with strategy. By the end of this video, you will know how to use Jira plans to model scenarios, manage capacities, and visualize your projects like pro. How we can begin with it? Let me show you in details. Let's begin with David's scenario where he was struggling with a lot of things. I wanted to create a plan. I will add the name as David plan. It is open access to all this user, and here instead of selecting boards, you will have project and filter options also available, where you can either select board. Whenever you select, you will get all those board options. You can also select projects as well as filter. Whichever you are comfortable with it, you can select it. As of now, I have design. Once David will create this plan, you will see this interface available, where you'll have all the projects which is added successfully. Whenever we'll jump to the screen, you'll see this is a basic wizard where you'll have all the issue types are added. You can also switch or toggle this button from list to timeline view, and this will be enabled the Gantt chart view for you. Even you can keep it to list view for basic wizard. Whenever you want, you can add sorting, grouping icon, dependencies, rollups, dates. You can enable it at any point of time. Now, if you wanted to apply some filters, like you wanted to just see project features, you can just add this and navigate it to down, and you will have project features enabled for you. Whichever filter you want, you can add it, like releases. If you wanted to just select teams, assigning, sprint, any details which you are looking forward to get it, into plans, you can easily do it. That's the basic wizard in plans. Next section is capacity mode, where you can add your team's capacities, and accordingly you will get to know how much teams are still pending with it. What is the efforts teams are doing? What is the availability of the resources? These all details you will get it from here, where you have to estimate in number of days and then update the details. Let me add some details here. Teams, whichever teams you have added, you can add it and add the releases. If you have at any point of time you wanted to add any other details, you can even add it from this plus icon. Like if you're looking for some specific fields which is not available here, you can add it at any point of time. These details can be customized in different way. By default, we have basic view. You can even add sprint capacity management, dependency management, and top level planning. All the details are available. At any point of time, you want to customize your plans. So before that, let me save and update the details. It will update the details and you'll have unsaved changes, nothing available. If I realize I missed some projects here, maybe I will go back and just go to the plan settings, and from here, I will try to update the project program boards. Here I can add plan lead, mobile applications roadmap, and wherever I want, I can add any projects from here. So as of now, we have 96 items. Removed work items, we don't have anything, but I can even add more details, like I will include some other projects as well. So whenever I feel I wanted to include some more projects into my boards or plan, I will be able to easily do it. Click on save and you'll have, or David will have, more number of items added. It means cross projects also we can see it in plans. Whenever I want, I can just edit plan scope, and that's it for me, or that's it for David. So it means customization is possible. Whenever you want, you can just add or remove boards as well as projects. And accordingly, this plan will be visible in front of you. The more projects you'll include, the more data is available and you have to work on it. Consider David's project manager asked him to include all the projects which is running. He will immediately go to the settings and he will update the details as and when required. And he can also see entire company's estimations, capacity of the team who is available. He will get to know immediately. Consider suddenly the backend team of David gets pulled into a security patch sprint where they will still deliver on time. This is how David can modify the details. So he models this in the sandbox. Nothing breaks in Jira, but David sees delivered would slip by 2 weeks, where he can go to the plan update from here, and from the plan setting, he will include whichever details he want. If he wanted to remove or add some rules, he can add some rules, or view work items or releases, he can tag it from there. So from the scenario modeling, let's David test changes, prioritize and evaluate outcomes before making it officials. That's where capacity planning plays in a role, and project plan can be modified easily. David's no longer buried in spreadsheets. His roadmap's clear, his teams are aligned, and the mobile launch is back on track where he can track it easily, where he will see clear and concise reports where he can save it at any point of time. If he wanted to clear all those filters, once he'll clear it, he will see all the information which is available here. Priority is also, he will have all the information which is listed. And that's where David will feel relaxed, right? This is the capacity view. Next will be dependencies. If David, project manager, wanted him to target dependencies and risk as well, he can immediately change the view to the dependencies, and which all dependency he has, he will show it to his manager. At any point of time, he wanted to do the modifications into dependencies, he can also do it in dependency wizards, where he will clearly modify dependencies from here or see entirely. If he wanted to add any other dependencies, he can immediately target the details with any of those issues, and new dependencies will be added successfully. Till the time you will not save it, or till the time David will not see it, it will be not available. So that is how dependencies will be tracked, added, and modified. If you want, even you can fit into the board or reset. Maybe you can increase or decrease the image size, which should be visible. Dependency also have different filters available. If you want, you can group by, you can even add it project wise dependencies, or you can see project wise dependencies as well. If David wants, he can even see dependency based on the sprints. Work items, any point of time he wanted to see based on the work items, that is also available. The way he want, he can keep control in his hands, and his life will be much more easier. At any point of time, he wanted to see issue link type blocks, which is the other category. He can easily get it added or viewed from his Jira plan boards. Now, David wanted to showcase the entire company projects into high level view, where he can see top level view for entire projects, what is the progress, issue count, where we are lying, everything is available. Start date, end date, release components, everything is visible for his business team or for his top level management team, where they can easily see the status or updates of any projects at any point of time, which is much more easier for David to explain to their management team where we are lying in terms of progress. And finally, if David have desired permissions, he can even jump into the permission scheme, where he can plan as an administrator or add some plan administrator users as well as plan viewers. At any point of time, he can create control high level of the plans, where who can see this plan will be added successfully. Dependencies also can have more number of actions will be added, like instead of just blocks, we can add action items, cloners, deployments, developer explanations. These all things David can easily add it. Hierarchy configurations can also be done by using this, but this, as I've already covered in my previous videos, I will not touch base. As of now, I wanted to show you just Jira plans as well as capacity tracker, how David can make his life easier. Question for you is, have you ever tried Jira plans before? What's your biggest planning challenges which you can see? Feel free to add your answer in comments. This could be helpful for the other viewers. They could learn from your comments. And which features would you like to deep dive in next videos? Dependencies, capacities, or any other features, feel free to add in comment sections. Till then, happy learning, and we'll see you in next video. If you like this video, feel free to add some feedback, suggestions, or comment, and don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching. We'll see you in next video.